Hello everyone and welcome back to PolyNerdic Plays The Wolf Among Us. If you were watching early this morning, you know that we have probably like a little less than an episode and a half to go. We're about two-thirds of the way through episode 4, and then there's episode 5. I'm really enjoying this story. I'm very eager to wrap it up. I'd like to thank those of all of you that came and watched last night. I appreciate the views. And I hope some of you make your back to watch this, or at least come and follow up with it on YouTube. Because it was a really interesting story, a really fun game. I've enjoyed myself, but I am very eager to see how this story wraps up. So let's, without further ado, just jump right in. Excuse me.
I don't care who killed the prostitutes. If Crane was helping himself to the community coffers, it means his hand was in my pocket, and you just let him go!
I don't know what you heard, but it didn't happen like that.
Are you denying the facts?
She's denying me the chance to get a word in. Now, Miss White,
Sheriff Bigby has returned.
Ah, there's the old wrecking ball himself.
Bigby, where have you been?
I'm not finished here, Miss White.
You will have to wait. Just one moment, please.
Look what I found.
Seems your dog wants a biscuit.
I'm not in the mood. And you've got a lot to answer for.
Oh, really?
Buffkin, get this piece in the mirror right away.
With pleasure, Miss White.
Finally, things are swinging back in the right direction. Good work, Bigby. You've been gone all day. What did you uncover? I thought you were going to report back to me. I mean, it's fine. So what else did you find out?
I gotta say, this thing reaches a lot further than we thought. The Crooked Man has something on everybody. It wasn't just Beauty and the Loan. Beast was working for him. His goon, the Jersey Devil, is putting the squeeze on all kinds of fables down at the Lucky Pawn. He was even running black market magic out of the butcher shop. But that's over now. Because we got the mirror. And once it's fixed, we got him. That's how Crane did it. That's how we're gonna do it.
Excellent work. Really.
Sheriff, I could use your assistance. Would you join me at the mirror?
Don't go far, Sheriff. I'd like to have a few words of my own with you.
Why the hell did you burn Crane's stuff, huh? Don't bullshit me. Buffkin was there. I know it was you.
Given Ichabod's obsession with Miss White, I thought it best to make sure that nothing untoward saw the light of day.
Oh, fuck off. I know you were burning evidence.
Then tell me, what evidence did I burn?
I have more important things to deal with right now. You can be sure that we're gonna have a long fucking talk about this when I'm done.
I do so enjoy our talks. I'll wait with bated breath.
Old Bluebeard.
I don't understand. This piece just doesn't want to join the rest. Do you have any idea why?
Got me.
Well, where did you find it? What has it gone through since being separated from the rest? Shattering is a very traumatic experience, you know. So this process can be a little touchy.
I found it at the butcher shop, the cut above. It was in Crane's coat. There was a lot of weird magic going on there. That has something to do with it. Other than that, the last person I saw with Crane or his coat was that psycho Bloody Mary. Maybe she had something.
Ah, yes, Miss White was asking about her. That explains it. You know who and the mirror have a very unhappy history with each other. How would you like it if she tried to use you as a doorway?
I think I already know the feeling.
Well, I think I know how to proceed now. It will just take a little extra coaxing. That's all. Thank you for your help. It could be a while, Sheriff. I'll find you when it's ready.
Of course.
Besides which, he might not want to come out with you watching.
Oh, he doesn't like being spied on.
If you ask me, you're everything that's wrong with Fabletown.
Is it fixed? Did you ask about the Crooked Man?
Buffkin's still working on it. He said it might be a while.
If you're so self-reliant, what do you want from the business office of Bank?
What I want is my business.
I can't take those two right now. We're trying to catch a murderer, and they're... They're over there bickering about bureaucracy. We're at war. Don't they realize that?
You need some help over there?
Yeah, thanks. Go talk to Toad. But just so you know, we can't pay him. He really needs to go to the farm, you know. So just break the news and be done with it, okay?
No bite on that bloody glamour. I only came in to see about it.
Toad, come here.
I thought I made myself very clear.
I see how it is. Passed off to an underling, eh?
Why am I not surprised?
Well, you did cause what damage brings me in here, so maybe it's for the best. Just need a little bit of dosh to cover it. I tried talking to her about it, but it's like chatting up a brick wall, it is. Now, I'm sure you've got your own agenda, Sheriff, but I've taken a real wallet because of you.
I'm starting to think you don't take me seriously, Toad. How many times have I told you to get glamored up? You know that if you're out of glamour, I gotta send you to the farm.
Well, how about your friend the pig, hmm? Is he going to the farm too? Yeah, you thought we didn't know about him, huh?
Wouldn't you know it? Colin is going to the farm.
Well, I would say each case deserves to be decided on its own merits, don't you think? If you give me one more chance and hear me out, I'll see a way for me and me boy to stay. I'm not gonna ask for any more than I need. I just wanna stay. So what do you say? You just give me enough to cover me glamours and we'll call the rest a wash. Please, Sheriff, don't take TJ from the only army knows. He's so glamorous, oppressive. I've done nothing wrong but look different.
Look, you were unglamored 3 days ago, and you're still unglamored now. I can't ignore that. But you go to the farm, things cool down here a bit. Maybe you can come back at some point. Best I can do.
What a crock of shite. Government by the fables, for the fables, my arse.
Bluebeard, you want to talk? Now's your chance.
I've just made my donation funding this office, so direct your questions to Miss White.
Well, at least he's not trying to get rid of me.
He's not?
For now. Did you take care of Toad? I mean, I saw the way he left. I know it may not seem that important right now, but glamours are the law for a very good reason. You know that as well as anyone.
Don't worry. I did the right thing.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. I know I should be asking how it got like this, but I just keep wondering why it happened to Faith and Lily. You've seen his world. Do you have any idea why he'd want them dead? I don't know if the Crooked Man killed them with his own hand or if it was one of his goons, but someone did.
I don't know, but when I catch the fucker who did this, I'll find out why.
Sheriff! Miss White! I believe the mirror is repaired.
I have to say I have been better, but thanks for putting me back together.
I'm sorry, I have to know. Mirror, mirror, we're glad you weren't slain. Now please show us that sick creep Crane.
Yeah, I want to see where he's ended up to.
You will get on that plane to Paris, and you will wait for the day the Crooked Man needs you. Until then, not a peep. Otherwise, I get to deal with you my way. So please, please disobey. Wait a minute. Someone's watching.
Bloody Mary.
What just happened?
We pointed you in the wrong direction. Looked at Bloody Mary's reflection.
Oh, her. That explains the sting. I'd rather not have to feel the pain she brings. So, let's not do that again, okay?
Looks like we'll have to track him down later.
You're right. We need to focus on the immediate threat, and that's the Crooked Man. Bigby, we don't have a lot of time.
Mirror, mirror, no time to pout. So, where does Crooked Man hang out?
God, he's awful.
I I don't recognize the door, but that's the Crooked Man symbol on it.
Hold on.
It's moved.
A door. It moves.
Yeah, Jersey mentioned that.
Wait a minute. I know that door.
That's Central Park. I don't know when it's gonna move again, but I'm gonna get there before it does.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial. We can't just dispense street justice. I know that emotions can run high, and you have your reasons to handle this a certain way.
I'll catch him and bring him back here, alive. Then we can clean him and cook him together.
Good. I have enough to worry about here while I prepare the case against him. So I'm going to trust you to handle this properly. That is, if you think you're ready.
Of course I'm ready. I got no other choice.
Ended his evil ways. Chapter 5 of episode 4 is now in the books. It was a short chapter. Shot from the first scene of the game. Oh, interesting. He wasn't that far away from it a second ago. Now the glyph burns off. Still gonna have problems with the scene transitions. Is that what we're doing, game?
Tim!
Tiny Tim.
What the hell are you doing here?
Good evening, Sheriff. I'm here to take you to the boss. Thanks, by the way, for leaving off Tiny. I have to admit, when they asked me to watch the door, I wasn't sure what to expect when you came through that portal. I know you aren't here on a social call.
What is this place? Or where is it? I know I'm not in Central Park anymore.
I'm not sure. I've only ever come in through one of the portals. I don't think you can get in from the actual street. But you can't blame him for wanting to make it hard to find. I'm supposed to bring you right on in, so if you'll come this way. Look, this is the one thing I have to do.
Fine, lead on.
Old Tiny Tim. I love that this game just pulls, this world just pulls from all the public domain fiction.
Thanks for understanding. This is all I'm here to do, and I don't want to mess it up. I know I'm probably the last person you'd expect to be a guard, or an escort for that matter. I was a little surprised myself when they asked me to do it. I thought it was a joke, actually.
I get it. You have a job to do. But you gotta ask yourself if you want to be involved with this guy.
Whatever you may think of him, he doesn't treat me like some broken little kid. I think he gets what it's like. He gave me a job, and I'm lucky to have it. This is the only option I've got. Just keep that in mind, maybe? Because if you and the boss go up against each other, the rest of Fabletown is gonna get caught in the middle. And if you're here, it can't be good. So I hope you two can come to an understanding.
I understand the position you're in, but you don't have to do this. There are other things you could do.
So it's just that easy.
Maybe not, but you don't want to be a part of this.
A lot of us depend on him. Some of us never get to the front of the line at the business office. But he's there. We
yeah,
it
sounds like
you,
the bureaucracy has created this monster.
Too. What we don't need is a war. Hey, Sheriff, hold up. I gotta go in with you. Thanks.
Am I some kind of fucking joke to you? What did I tell you, eh? Stop laughing.
Tell me who the fuck is back there.
I ain't scared.
I don't exactly know. I just mind the door. The boss is there.
Don't worry. Maybe that much. And like Crane before him, I'm sure he will prove himself quite handy to have in my pocket. Either he's smart enough to see this is for the best, or dim enough to do as he's told.
That won't be necessary. Sheriff Wolf, sir.
Hey, wait a minute, I killed one of them.
Thank you, Tim. I know the sheriff isn't the accommodating sort, but you handled it. You did well. You can go now.
Thank you, sir.
You see, everyone in Fabletown has a role to fill. You just have to pay attention to what they need to help them find it. Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
All right, you got me here. Let's talk.
The end of the chapter? Yep.
I've heard stories about you. In the old days, how you picked off those men one by one. Oh, how they screamed. The wolf is coming. And they would wait, hiding anywhere they could squeeze their pathetic, shivering corpses. Some would just drop to their knees where they stood, close their eyes, and wait for death. And you'd give it to them. I wish I could have seen it. Oh well.
Chick's crazy. Okay, moving on. We're gonna jump into the final episode here. So get past the credits. I'm a little befuddled by the fact that I ripped the throat out of one of the Tweedles. And they're both there. But then again, we've seen characters survive multiple fatal wounds. So here we go, final episode. Final episode, let's roll right into this.
I mean, your eyes and the teeth. You're not really supposed to do that, are you?
Yeah, right there, I ripped his throat out when I played it. For some reason, it's not showing it anymore. I don't know if that's a glitch thing that's fucked it up or what.
Lily.
Do you even give a shit about us? The strays?
That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it?
We're destroying the tree. No!
We're not burning the tree, Snow.
Hey. You're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you?
The rules are the rules. I don't get to make them, I just enforce them.
Bullshit.
Ah!
this time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial.
Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
All right, right into the title card sequence this time. Alright, final episode.
You've
come
a long way. You must be tired. And if my envoys are correct, you haven't had a lot of rest recently. Please, Sheriff. Relax for a moment, will you? Do you want a drink? Something to eat? Vivian makes a very nice, very... It's elegant. Really a carpaccio. It's lobster. Sirloin.
I'm here for one reason, and it's not to eat your fucking food.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you think you're doing?
He's gonna...
Mr. Wolf is our guest, and I have every intention of cooperating. So don't waste the silver.
Yeah.
Sit down, Jersey. Well, Sheriff, for the sake of transparency, why don't you tell us why you're here? It would help settle everyone's nerves, I think.
You're destroying this town. You've been doing it for ages.
Destroying this town? What on earth do you mean?
What the hell do you think I mean? Slavery? Kidnapping? Extortion? Murder? What would you call the wholesale corruption of Fabled Town?
I would call it the baseless accusation of a desperate sheriff. How are you certain this isn't some conspiracy against me? I'm a well-connected man. Well-moneyed. People do like to take their shots at me.
You're right that there's a conspiracy. But you're the one behind it.
I have no need for treachery, Bigby. I do everything right out in the open. But I can understand the confusion, and I'm truly sorry about the trouble all this has caused you. And I hope you believe me when I say, Sheriff, that I sincerely mean to make it up to you. The recent murders that have gotten such attention as of late, I don't relish telling you that they were perpetrated by an employee of mine. It's a very unfortunate bit of business, but I promise you that the matter will be dealt with internally. I just want to settle the issue for you and to assure you that it's over with. You really don't need to worry yourself further.
An unfortunate bit of business? You're gonna tell me right now who killed him?
Sheriff, I have complete respect for you and your job. I hope you know that. But I simply can't divulge that information. You really shouldn't worry yourself. As I said, I've got this under control.
No, I'm gonna deal with it right now.
Yeah, right. What do you think this is? Some kind of negotiation? The man said he'd take care of it. So why don't you take the hint and get out?
I'm the law here, not you. Now tell me who did it.
You think I'm scared of you? You're nothing more
That's
than a-
That's enough! I was hoping it wouldn't come to this, but in the interest of preserving our alliance, if you have to know, it was Georgie. However, like I said, I'd be handling the matter if you don't mind.
Georgie, you got what you wanted, so just...
Sit down now.
Jersey Devil looks like a scuzzball.
Yeah, I killed him, so what? You should have just kept your nose where it fucking belonged.
You piece of shit. I should have fucking known.
Look, the fact is... George here misinterpreted one of my instructions.
Misinterpreted?
And I want to make things right. So, let's work something out.
What's there to work out? I'm protected, aren't I?
Your protection has limits, and I think you've far exceeded yours. But you could murder someone in cold blood like that.
You fucking asked me to do this!
And then attempt to blame me for it. You will be silent while we discuss what to do with you.
This is right bollocks, sis! You're just gonna let him do this?
So what do you say, Sheriff? Can we discuss terms? You can have Georgie. Consider it a gift. Ensuring our continued cooperation.
What the hell?
I think I'll be taking both of you.
You're not taking me, you fucking punts. What the fuck is this shit? You said you'd cover for us.
For minor infractions, not murder.
Just go with him, Georgie. You're gonna sink us all.
What's wrong with you people? You're really gonna sell him out just like
you
that?
You think I give a fuck if I'm the one... Who the shit do you think you fuckers
are? Get the fuck out of here!
I do apologize, Sheriff, but I think it's best if you leave now.
There's no way I'm going with him! Are you kidding me?
Things are about to get unpleasant, and I would rather you weren't here to watch.
You can go join that whore at the bottom of the lake for all I give a shit, but he's not taking me anywhere. I'll roll over on the lot of you before I let that shit happen.
What are you saying?
I already told you. I'm taking both of you in, so let's go.
This could have gone so well. To speak the truth, I've never been a very good mediator. Why negotiate when you can just decide?
Your old Bloody Mary.
Did I miss anything good? Well, look at you, all fixed up.
Come on. Break the momentum of the action with this shit.
Take this!
Again, we're gonna... This game has some technical issues.
You're done, Wolf!
Come on, we're pretty much done here.
I'd like to say it was nice knowing you, but I'll be glad to see your insides turned out.
Alright, come on. These damn pauses here are annoying. Yeah.
Oh god.
George had what he had got what he had coming. I hit Y.
This way.
Five down.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shit!
I know.
Clothes that are identical to what he normally wears. White shirt, pants, and a tie. And we get the standard delay as it changes scenes. Not sure what the fuck's up with that. That's annoying as hell, though. You did it, jackass. Surprised by the amount of blood that's coming from the guy you stabbed in the gut.
Wait a minute.
Okay.
Shit. Hello, Bigby. I hoped you'd come to your senses. Crooked Man's the one you want. But of course, you're too much of an idiot to see that. Or maybe you just like me too much to let me go.
I'm taking you in, Georgie. Let's go.
You gonna carry me?
Please, Sheriff.
Haven't you done enough? Look at him. He's dying.
You can't seriously want to protect this guy. You know what he did.
I'm not going anywhere. It isn't his fault.
He's a murderer. Faith and Lily, he's the reason they're dead.
Look, I know he made a few mistakes. We all have.
What?
He made sure they couldn't talk with those damn ribbons, and then he killed them. You're wearing one yourself. Doesn't that bother you even a little, knowing that man murdered...
Of course it does. Those girls...
So it's all my fucking fault, then. You're gonna throw me to the fucking wolf, too? You know I didn't have a goddamn choice. What the fuck? I did what I had to! You can't fucking blame me for that.
Why'd you do it then, huh? If it's not your fault, then what the fuck happened?
Look, Faith and the others tried to pull a run on us. And as you can imagine, the crooked man wasn't too thrilled. But of course, the big boss didn't want to get his fucking hands dirty. So he told me to take care of it. You think I don't know what that means? Either I do what he says or I'm the one getting dealt with. So I fucking killed him. And I'd do it again. Because it's not my fault. The crooked man gave the order. He told me to kill them. And then he fucking sold me out.
You're still the one who pulled the trigger. Nobody held your hand and made you go through with it.
Ryan, believe what you want. I can tell you've made up your mind. Doesn't matter if it's fucking true or not. Go ahead and arrest me then. But it won't bring back Lily or Faith. It won't free your friend Narissa. And I'm just the sap taking the fall for the whole thing. It must be so easy being you. Just come in here and blame me for all this shit. Job's done, right? George is the bad guy. It's all his fucking fault. But what was I supposed to do? You don't know what it's like, Bigby. How could you know?
You could have done anything else. You could have let them go. You could have freed Faith and Lily from those fucking ribbons instead of murdering them.
You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. If I freed them... What would you have me do? Kill her?
Georgie, don't.
It was them or Vivian. So you tell me, if freeing Lily meant she had to die... Do you still think I had a fucking choice?
What are you doing?
Hey, leave her out of this, Georgie.
This is the original... The girl with the ribbon. I'm sure you've heard the stories. Couldn't take it off, couldn't talk about it. She used her little purple ribbon to make more of them. To keep our girls quiet. To ensure absolute discretion.
You promised you wouldn't.
All that magic is connected to this little thing. You remove hers, and the spell's broken. They're all free. But you know what happens to her? The same thing that happened to Faith. So don't you come in here and tell me I fucked up.
What the hell, Georgie? We were supposed to look out for each other. I trusted you.
You can't fucking blame me. You're not innocent here either.
Wait, those were your ribbons?
Way to catch on,
Bigby.
You're
in on this? I thought you cared about them.
I do. Of course I do. You have to understand, nobody was supposed to die. When we built this place, it was just a stupid idea. A gimmick. Discretion is our guarantee. That's how it started anyway. This was supposed to be our place. We were going to be in charge for once, and nobody would try to control us or use us. That was the point. Then the crooked man showed up, and everything just turned to shit.
So, do you get it now? Why I couldn't just... If you still think it's so fucking simple, then you do it. Go right ahead. Kill her, then.
What are you doing?
Break the spell. Save the fucking day!
Stop it!
I told you, sometimes all your options are shit.
Fuck.
Why should you get to decide? Either of you. You think this is hard for you? My life is such a fucking burden on your conscience. Don't I get a say?
You imprisoned
other
people.
It's my life. Like it was either of yours to give up in the first place.
You don't get a choice if you're involved in this.
I know what I've done.
Wait!
I'm sick of everyone thinking that they can just do what they want with my life. I thought it would be different here. But it's all the fucking same.
Vivian, I didn't mean...
Do you think I wanted to be this person? What I did to Faith and Lily? To all of them?
Vivian, wait!
Every day I have to look Gwen and Hans in the eye and pretend I don't care. I have to forget what I've done to them, what I took away from them. I look at Nerissa and I hate myself.
Vivian!
I can't pretend anymore.
What are you doing? Vivian, don't!
Wait.
Goodbye, Vivian! Georgie. No!
Fuck! Okay, that's poorly written because he was all willing to take it off himself. And then
why'd
you
have to do that, Vivian? Vivian!
Just. Jesus.
You were getting ready to pull the ribbon yourself.
Vivian, I didn't fucking mean it. I was just.
Get up. Get
up! Don't think so, Bigby. I'm gonna die here. I think we both know that. Just make sure you give the crooked man the same treatment when you find him. Really fuck him up for me, all right?
He's gonna have it worse. Don't worry.
Georgie will remember that for the next 30 seconds.
Old
so
foundry by the river. All right? Shepherd Metalworks. He'll be there. Fucking asshole. You want to finish me off now? Or do you plan to kick me around a little first? Rip my limbs off one by one? That's what you want to do, right?
That's not who I am.
Sure it's not. No more games, all right? We both know how this ends. Just make it quick. I know what I did.
All right, Georgie.
God, that's brutal. I guess that's justice somewhat. I'm just gonna go get the crooked man. Thank you. Okay, we got just a door. Well, we'll look at.
So this is where they've been sending these.
Light turned on as I approached it.
Bigby Wolf. The big bad wolf. You used to be something. They used to fear you.
What the hell?
Shivering bodies with
it. It's the crooked man's torture device thing. Sometimes the controls in these leave a lot to be desired. Beauty, Bluebeard, Jack Horner, Flycatcher. There's a lot of debts over there. Pinocchio. Silver bullets.
Silver.
The big bad wolf. It's about time you showed up.
I had to take care of some things first.
Little errand boy. That's nice.
Ah, Bigby. I see you made it here in one piece. I do apologize, but I have some business to attend to. I leave you in the capable hands of my associate. Come find me when you finish, dear.
Don't worry. This won't take long.
Get out of my way, now. Don't make this worse.
Aw, he doesn't want to play.
I'm sure you'll persuade him.
Cut this shit out!
Didn't your mother ever teach you manners? Oh, was she too busy fucking whatever breeze drifted through town?
Wow.
Oh, come on! Is that the best you can do?
The fuck she disappeared to? Where are we going? What the hell just happened? I missed it. look down for a second. Damn it.
Where are you? Come out and face me!
Damn quick button inputs. Oh. True form? Load screens, man. Happens every time there's a point where the game's saving as it changes scenes, it freezes up. That was crazy. Chapter 3. All right, we're getting close. In fact, I'm going to take a quick moment to pause there and use the restroom real fast. I'll be right back. Just sit tight, and we'll wrap up this Wolf Among Us game.